Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the world-famous Jazz Pepper Club. It is my pleasure to introduce... We seem to have an unexpected guest. Frankie?
Where to, miss? You need a map? It's confusing around here.
I can't wait to see my dad. I haven't been to his Jazz Pepper Club in ages. Plus, it's Mardi Gras time. Oh, it's good to be back in New Orleans.
Here we are, Chestnut Street, home of the world-famous Jazz Pepper Club. Much appreciated. Careful out there, miss. Some funny things have been happening. It's a slow night. I'll hang around just in case.
Yeah, I know the owner. Samuel, he treats me right. Not everyone does. But he doesn't let me drink as much as I want. Says it's bad for me. Yeah, I was going back for a nightcap or two, but I don't feel so good. My poor head. Oh, you don't have anything I can take, do you? Me? Thanks. Much better. Well, now I need to get home while I can still walk a straight line. Here, this is my spare key to the club for emergencies.
Thank you.
I grew up without a mom. It was hard losing her so young. Hard on my dad, too. We were crushed, but we weren't alone. My Aunt Adele was always there for us.
It hits you like a freight train. All you do is flinch. Everything stop up with pain. You can't move an inch. You're caught in a frozen embrace. I shall do my part. Just take a look at my loving face. Let me move your heart.
What's going on here? You, what happened here? So you just found them this way? Okay, you're free to go, but I'll need you to stay in town.
The stage area is closed. Please move to the right. The stage area is closed. Please move to the right.
Sorry, but I can't let you in. The undead are roaming the city. Show me the protection amulet, so I know you're not one of them. Sorry, but I can't let you in. The undead are roaming the city. Show me the protection amulet, so I know you're not one of them. The shop next door. Ah, those old doors can be tricky to open. Give them a shake. Left, left, right, left, right. That should do it.
My cigar! Oh, nearly started a fire. Huh? Who dat? Oh, goodness, Cher. I must have nodded off. I'm Ted Lafayette, but everyone calls me Curly. You need something repaired? Sacolet. This case belonged to Frankie Tuxedo Bolden himself. One of the world's greatest sax players. He was with the Dixie Peppers, you know. My favorite band. Why, I even have their first LP. Frankie died too young and was replaced by Samuel Sterling. Frankie was one of a kind. I'd sell my soul to hear him play just once more. I'd been on vacation for 2 weeks. My assistant must have taken that order. The serial number is SA001DP. I'll check my records to see who brought it in. Mind grabbing my record book from the drawers over there? I'll just rest a bit. Mon Dieu! Not again! Look through that mess. Something might help you. Oh, good. You found the repair code. Let me get that name. Here, I've marked the page. My shop, my beautiful instruments, such loss. I must call the firemen.
You okay? There's some fire, but help's on the way. They didn't play in the fancy New Orleans clubs, but they sure could raise the heat.
Thank you.
Benny Brass Peterson played trumpet like he was possessed, and his music possessed everyone. They say Eddie Jr. Edwards kept the beat of his bass with his heart, not his hands. Tom Moolah Brown danced over the piano keys fast as lightning and more powerful than thunder. Frankie Tuxedo Bolden was on sax. His solos were a life lesson. When Adele Goldie Sterling sang, it was like electricity crackling in the air. Together, they were the Dixie Peppers, a band dreaming of the big time. They had their own sound, and in New Orleans, that meant fame and fortune. But in the beginning, the street was their stage. They played for anyone walking by. The Dixie Peppers didn't care. Just playing music was magical for them. But magic didn't pay the bills, and rich music lovers don't gather in the streets. They needed a break, and soon, or their instruments would find their way to the pawn shop.
Date, August 1946. Samuel Sterling, personal notes. It appears someone brought Frankie back. But who and why? Whatever the reason, he's targeting the old band members, one by one.
This is your own fault for meddling.
Come on, get in. That was close. That was the killer from the news. If I were you, I'd pack my stuff and get out of here.
Yes, what do you need? You have a protection amulet. Where did you find it? Come on, let's talk inside. Welcome to the House of the Moon. My name is Lucy. Lucy Robertson. You can call me Luna. How can I help you? It looks like some sort of protection amulet. You could find out more about it here, for a small fee, of course. Why, that's very unfortunate. Perhaps we can come to a different agreement. A little favor could work, in lieu of payment. I'm looking for hardwood ashes for one of my potions. Could you find some for me? The tragedy next door would be a good place to look for some, but it would not be very neighborly of me to profit from that misfortune.
Thank you for offering to help. Perhaps together we can get my shop working again one day.
Thank you. Yes, this will do. You can look around the shop and find the information you seek. I have a book of charms, trinkets, and amulets on the table, and additional info can be found somewhere in the shop.
Thank you.
The amulet of resurrection can raise the dead from the grave. Fortunately, the amulet of vigor can protect the living from these monstrosities.
I hope you found what you're looking for. I couldn't help noticing that old book you carry. Mind if I take a look at it? I just love old books. One can learn a lot from them. Sadly, this one is destroyed beyond repair. However, I have just a thing for it. A solution of my own invention will restore the book. Here, take it.
calendar now for the 18th. It's time for me to show them I've returned. It's time for me to show them what I can do. It's all about time, which was stolen from me. Yes, Frankie, but now you have a chance to set things right. Shed some light on your mystery, in front of everyone. I'm not interested in what's right. All I want is vengeance. My heart burns for it. Frankie, this isn't what I brought you back for. You need to end this. Before it's too late, please, S-T-O-P, stop! Sorry, my roadmap doesn't show any stop signs. There's no changing your mind, is there? Just, what are your plans? I'll give them the show of their lives. I'll play them a tune they'll never forget. Don't, Frankie. It's not right. You don't have a pass anyway, thank goodness.
You escaped twice, but there won't be a third time. It's 8:45, and I'm due to play the mayor his last song. I'll be back for you.
Thank you.
All right, enjoy the parade.
No! I won't make it! I must save myself!
This is an invitation-only kind of place. I don't see yours, sweetie.
Stop right there. Who are you? Could it really be you? Oh, honey, I'm so sorry. You've grown up so much. Oh, the last time I saw you, you were just a little girl. Yes, I heard what happened to poor Sam. I'd like to help him. They say he returned, that he's somehow back from the dead? Frankie has returned, and he's picking us off one by one. There is no doubt. I'm the last of the Dixie Peppers, and that's why I bought this gun. Just let him come. He made quite a mess of Mardi Gras. I wanted to find out more, but my TV's busted. At least my radio still works. I have to start my show. These days, it's the only thing keeping me sane. It was a long time ago. He was a very different man back then. And I was a very different woman. At one point, Frankie changed. I don't like talking about it. Take this slide. It'll tell you the story better than I can. Thank you.
Not before long, the band's hard work and dedication started to pay off. Their first true gig was at a small French Quarter club, and great success. Pretty soon, the Dixie Peppers ruled the club scene and released their first record. But that's not where the money was in those days. They needed a permanent gig. Impressed by Frankie Solo's, a speakeasy owner hired them as the host band at his bar. They finally had the success and the wealth they had dreamed of for years. But it was not meant to last. Their performances were incredibly popular, and their fame quickly rose. But almost straight away, money brought tension between the band members. When they were struggling, the band were close and shared earnings equally. But Frankie now felt that he was the sole reason for the band's success. He started stealing the spotlight and soon demanded a larger cut of the money. The others were appalled at this, and his budding romance with Adele was in danger. A dark time was coming for the Dixie Peppers.
Where the latest attack of the mysterious killer occurred, the prime target seems to have been Tom Brown, our mayor. But numerous visitors are reported to have been paralyzed as well. This is Jenny Sue, reporting live from the Mardi Gras Festival.
Oh my! The detective I hired to investigate was at the Mardi Gras Festival too. You've got to find him. He might know something. Here's a picture of him. Now, you better catch a cab. Remember to dial 824. Hurry!
Norman's Taxi Service, how can we help you? One moment, please. Your taxi will be there in 3 minutes.
Nice to see you again. Where to?
This is Detective Hutchinson investigating a case involving a saxophonist. Step forward to the map and observe. Since I dismissed the silly notion of a dead man coming back to life, my only remaining suspect is Benny. Here are the conclusions I made during my surveillance of him. July 9th, I followed the suspect from the car repair shop to the instrument workshop. Then he got a haircut at the barber shop and picked up some medicine at the local pharmacy. After having lunch at a local cafe, he walked to the library where he spent the rest of the afternoon. July 10th, the suspect got up early for fresh produce at the market before buying a new pair of shoes. In the afternoon, he had a long appointment at his lawyer's office and then spent the evening at the Jazz Pepper Club. July 11th, another ordinary day. The suspect got a tux fitted at the tailor's and then hung out at the local pub. July 13th, the suspect went to the cinema, but there was nothing playing, so he saw a play at the theater instead. July 14th, the suspect went to the dentist and then stopped by a warehouse to pick up some instruments he had stored there.
Thank you.
Where to, miss?
Did you hear that?
I'm supposed to guard Frankie's grave, but this place is giving me the creeps. John, from the previous shift, he told me he heard a cracking sound and he saw a ghost. I hope he was lying.
Thank you.
The band kept playing, but the rift between them grew. Right before their biggest gig yet, Frankie was furious. His bandmates had refused his final request for more money. But this time, it was serious. He was leaving the band forever. Adele tried to stop him, but he slammed the door shut. Everyone panicked. The gig was that night, and their star was gone. And as if by command, their eyes all turned to Adele. Everyone insisted that she should go after Frankie. They were lovers no more. But if anyone could reach him, it was her. She knew he'd be back at his place, venting anger through a sack solar. Harsh words were spoken. Adele kept at it, but Frankie snapped and pushed her away. Stumbling to her feet, she grabbed the old gun Frankie kept by his bed. Trembling, she gave him one last chance to reconsider. He leapt at her. As they wrestled for the gun, it went off. Frankie fell without a sound.
What was that? song of stone brings chaos to the mind and paralyzes the listener. The song of water calms the mind and frees the listener.
Thinking of escaping? Think again.
Try all you want, but you're not leaving this car. This will teach you to meddle in other people's affairs. Too bad it's the last lesson you'll ever get. Have a nice swim.
This is my brother's life's work. Is he all right? Where did you get this? Someone took his scientific findings and used them for warped purposes. That's why everyone's paralyzed. Come upstairs with me. We need to talk. What? I need to save him somehow. Thanks for offering your help. Together we can stop all of this. My brother's tablet contains a powerful meditation tune called Song of Stone. All those people paralyzed, it's from the hypnotic song. It's psychology, not magic. No one can raise the dead. People attribute magical properties to things they don't understand. It's good for my business. To save all those people, we need to reverse the effect of the song. The opposite song is called Song of Water. Are you ready for some real-world chemistry? I hope you still have the restoration potion I gave you earlier. You'll need it. Look at that. I can't quite make it out, but I know the Song of Water is hidden on the tablet somewhere. You've got to head to the cellar to see my brother's papers. There might be something there to help decipher this.
Thank you. Thank you.
We need to record the Song of Water. Memorize and repeat the sequence. Careful now. Let's try that part again. It's got to be flawless. Good. Let's proceed to the next part of the song. You're doing great. You're almost there. You did it! You now have the Song of Water. The song's finished. Now we got to broadcast it. Excellent idea. That way the entire town will hear it. They will all be saved. Don't waste time walking. Take my car.
All righty. Come on in.
If this town's madness continues, I'll have to start revoking passes. The bar's empty. What brings you here? And Addie. Wait, you're Sam's daughter. Oh, look at you, as tall as a mast. I remember. Aunt Addie used to bring you in here for breakfast every Sunday. You loved my wife's omelets. Now, what's this about a steamer? Come again? Well, I changed it myself. Someone did that on purpose. I have an idea. I'll get an anchor big enough to hold it. You look for a chain. We can make a grappling hook and drag the boat to shore. Let's get going, sweetie.
Let's get this show going.
Frankie's death was an accident, but Adele was never quite the same. The Peppers grew apart, the band was done for, if not for Samuel Sterling. Adele's widowed brother and his little girl gave her life new meaning and purpose. Samuel, the brilliant sax player himself, took it upon himself to rebuild the band. Under his leadership, the whole world of jazz fans knew their names and music. Sam, Eddie, Benny, and Adele started their own businesses, and Tom went into politics. For about a decade, all was as it should be. But then came the threats. It started with crazy letters, which kept coming for months. At first, no one took the threat seriously. But the letters got more violent, with news clippings and cut-up photos of bandmates. Some of them got paranoid. Ed even thought he saw Frankie alive. He was convinced Frankie was back from the dead to terrorize them. One day, Ed met a sad and lonely death, and the killer wasn't done.
Let me see that photo. Wait a minute. I recognize the backside of it. It's a special ink that fades over time. I have a solution in my safe that will make it visible again. Unfortunately, I have difficulty remembering the code, but I do have a system for it. Hey, the combo's tattooed to my back. Help me read it off, will you? It was love at first sight, at least for me. We were young and so in love. Ah, the old days. But then, one day, our love ended. She left me for a better man. Broke my heart. That's when I decided never to settle again. Never to stay put. I was going to travel the globe. See the world. Be free. So I became a sailor. Wind in my hair. Endless sea, the fish and crabs in my net, my only company. I sailed all around the world. Saw strange things. Had some good luck, had some bad luck. Life of a sailor, eh? I remember this one day, this huge storm nearly sunk my ship. How I got to the coast, I don't even know. But the storm was child's play compared to those blasted pirates. They almost got me, but my ship was faster. And if you think storms and pirates were bad, wait till you hear about that giant octopus. I managed to shoot it with a harpoon and get away. It wasn't all bad, though. I remember in Tokyo, I met a beautiful geisha. That got me thinking about settling again. Only a woman can get a man to think like that, let me tell you. So I decided I had enough bruises and scars for one lifetime, and that it was time to drop the anchor again and find a home on land. I stayed right here in New Orleans, where I opened a bar for old sailors and sea wolves like me. These days, the only ship I see is Adele's steamboat. Can't say I mind, though. My sailing days are behind me. There we go. It's the code.
Over here! Nice job. Now give me a couple minutes and I'll pick this lock. He went into the cockpit and locked the door behind him. I saw him use it. The bars next to the door show how to set up the valves to open it. This guy's crazy. He's about to use the Zeppelin to broadcast some song over the entire city. He's gonna use it to get that woman he's after. The whole town will be affected by it.
You're too late. The Zeppelin's on a collision course. We're all going down together. Out of my way. Listen, everyone. This will be the final broadcast. It's done. I've punished everyone in this town. Bruno? I'm not Bruno. I'm Frankie. This body once belonged to Bruno, but now it belongs to me, Frankie. No! That was my only connection with my brother!
He's coming to his senses.
Police have apprehended the perpetrator of a terrible crime that's gripped New Orleans.
Police refuse to share details of the case, but we suspect some fast-thinking detective work was involved. All's well that ends well. This is Jenny Sue reporting live from the reopened Mardi Gras Festival.